I think it's a love letter to artists everywhere, and not just the ones in the sunlight, not just the ones who have succeeded or gained wide audiences, but also the vast majority of artists who never experience that or very rarely do. You know, that's most people who pick up a pen or a paintbrush or try to sculpt or make movies. Most of those people struggle in obscurity for most or all of their lives. But I see their struggle as just as noble as the ones who find themselves celebrated and immortalized. And this is their story too in a lot of ways. I think in some ways I'm saying you're not alone, because it can be lonely, you know, when these dreams in your head that never quite escape. But you're together with everyone. We're all going down, and this sounds a little morbid, but we're all going down that same chute, you know, to oblivion. Even the ones who may feel like they have some kind of guarantee of immortality, you know, it's just folly. One way or another, everyone gets forgotten. But there's something glorious about struggling against it, about not allowing the sun to go down too quickly. And it's just as noble for the obscure artist as it is for the ones with the big name. I was never able to coast because I didn't have as much natural talent as other artists. There are artists who've been drawing comics for only a few years who are already quite possibly better draftsmen than I'll ever be. And this was a disadvantage over time because I had trouble making my characters come alive on the page, something that's vitally important if you want to tell stories in comics. But with a lot of hard work, I think I've gotten better at that. And with a story that I cared about, I was able to finally bridge that gap, and I think I've done it better in this particular book.
I think that happens a lot in comics composition, is we get too hung up on the page. We're slaves to that rectangle. Yep.
I'd never used models before. This was brand new. And I had to kind of make it up as I went along. I had to use photography because I couldn't afford to pay somebody to stand and model for me 5 straight years as I drew the thing. For somebody who likes to theorize and come up with ideas on how comics work, you know, it's not the same as just sitting down and actually applying them. You know, test driving all of these ideas, all of these techniques. I just couldn't resist the opportunity to see if all of these ideas about comics could actually work in a narrative context. And it was very exciting to get a chance to finally do that.